Evan, and this is Shreya, and we are team Utor AI. What we are trying to do is make AI more accessible. Utor is used in Latin, so what we are trying to do is make AI more accessible by making it easy to use and cost effective. And we also thank Symphony for validating our idea in a way, because they just showed a chatbot, and we are also trying to do something in the similar space. The problem. There are a lot of startups today in India, but they lack good marketing channels and customer support. And a good solution to this is chatbots. These marketing channels are usually expensive, and customer support personnel are also quite expensive, and startups cannot afford this. So they are trying to build chatbots. But the problem is the existing platforms are very unfriendly. And using these platforms, you cannot build very powerful chatbots. If you want a powerful chatbot, it might sometimes even cost your entire seed fund. They cost such exorbitant packages. The solution that Utor AI has come up with is offering open source tools. These open source tools help developers around the world build their own chatbot. This also allows us to build a community around chatbot development and have our own platform works. Easy to use platform. Using this platform, anyone can build their own chatbots, and we are trying to make this very modular. So developers around the world can understand about the platform, build modules for this, and add utility. If the use case is too complex, then we also handcraft a chatbot.
Based on the recent startup market, we can see most of the companies require a great digital presence to attract clients. And most of the early stage startups, they cannot afford expensive marketing or customer support solutions. So they need to cut down cost prices. And one of the greatest impact right now is most of the millennials, they prefer text over long calls. So what we are trying to do is to bring companies to make their presence more on texting platforms and social medias. As you can see, our target market, we are trying to focus on startups who do not have a tech team of their own. So our primary target is non-tech startups. We have also seen that most of the educational institutions and urban hospitals can benefit a lot from the use of chatbots. The information can be broadcasted in a very effective way. Our target market is around 2,000 startups out of 7.7K startups and 500 educational institutions out of 4,000. And our target on urban hospitals is 1,200 hospitals out of 4,000 hospitals. Talking about our competitors are Haptic, Code.ai, Gupshup, and Smartbot. As you can see, most of our competitors offer handcrafted chatbots and bot building platform, but only Gupshup offers cost-effective pricing along with Utor AI, and only Haptic offers bot building tools along with Utor AI. The one thing that distinguishes us most is we offer modular architecture, which is not offered by any of the chatbot building companies as of now.
The unique value proposition is very important in this market because it's a very crowded space. Every other cool kid is building their own chatbot or is trying to use a chatbot building platform. So the one thing that distinguishes us is being modular, community friendly, and also cost effective. When we say modular, we are trying to encourage developers around the world to add utility to these chatbots with just a few clicks. And when we say community friendly, we are open sourcing all the tools that power our platform. This way, the developers understand how our platform works and they can help us make it more effective. Cost effective, because developers around the world are contributing, they also get a share in the price And this also helps us cut down the costs. The technology that powers all of this is a proprietary NLU engine that we are working on. This will be trained on specific domains. That is, for example, if you're targeting healthcare, then it will be trained on healthcare texts. Also, we all offer multi-language interop, that is multi-language interoperability. All existing platforms offer only, their extension modules are limited to one programming language, but we are working on a technology where the extension modules can communicate with our platform, no matter which language they're written in. We're also offering useful analytics, and all of this comes in real time and in the form of visual representations. So this can be quite useful to the user in fine-tuning his chatbot and also understanding how well it is working. The pricing model is also simple and pay-as-you-go. We offer the open source tools. So if your startup has a development team, they can use these tools to build their own chatbot. Or if you don't have a tech team, then you can use our platform, which is easy to use, and the pricing is 700 rupees per month. If your use case is too complex, then we talk to you, we sit with you, and handcraft the chatbot, and this costs 10,000 rupees a month. Based on this pricing, and based on some assumptions, we have come up with a financial model. We are trying to target 500 users by the end of the first year, and 2,000 users by the end of 2 years. And based on this, we are assuming based on the expenses that we need, we are asking for 35 lakhs. This will go into the server costs and also into the marketing that is required for this platform. At the end of 2 years, we are able to see a revenue of total revenue of 4 crores. So that is quite the market. But since it's also a platform, and even around the globe can use it, and the numbers can be quite bigger.
We recently developed a chatbot for Vardhman College of Engineering. It is on Facebook, where students can log in, they can get their GPA, attendance, timetables. And for the people who are not part of the college, they can get information from the bot, such as contact information and closing ranks of the college. It has definitely been successful, as I can say. Here is a screenshot from Vardhman Bot Analytics, which is taken from Facebook Analytics. As you can see, we had 630 distinct users. While there was an existing solution, a website provided by our college, where students can go, log in and get the same information. This proves how effective chatbots can be. I'm texting my friend, and I can also check my attendance. It's how easier can it be anymore?
Here is also a few screenshots of our platform that is currently under development. These are the kind of analytics we provide. It includes the number of unique users, the time spent with your chatbot, etc., which are quite useful in both fine-tuning and understanding how your users are responding to the chatbot. We also allow multiple bots in the same dashboard. So if your company has various places where you want to market or provide customer support, you can use the same dashboard to do that. Also, you can see how simple building a chatbot is. Just type a few sentences of how your user might talk to the chatbot, and your bot is trained, and immediately the bot can start responding. And you can add utility using the extension modules that are available in the module store. You can also add this chatbot to various channels. You don't know where your user might be. So you can have your chatbot on Facebook Messenger, Slack, Twitter, or Skype, or web, or Telegram. So this allows your chatbot to be present on various channels, and this allows increases your user base. Here's a team that includes me and Shreya, the head of research and development and marketing respectively. We also have our CEO Burhan Sheikh, Tarun Potilpati, our head of DevOps, and Khalid, head of design. All of us computer science graduates from Vardhman College of Engineering. This is a demo of our bot. The college website didn't provide us any separate API. So it was just built around what was already existing. And these are the kind of complex use cases that a chatbot can serve these days. I see a lot of smiles in the jury and the investors. And the person responsible for the savage replies is our head of design, Khalid Roshan. We also design such interactions, fine-tune them for startups and their respective domains. Thank you, that's the end of our presentation.
Over to the jury, please.
Yeah, you didn't speak about pricing. Let's say I'm a
you know, mid-sized hospital, 500-bed hospital.
Okay.
Not very savvy on my tech department, but I would love to take up a solution like this. What sort of pricing should I expect?
If you're interested in building your own chatbot, you can use our platform, and that costs 700 rupees a month. So that is the pricing we offer. If you think your use case is too complex, if you want to sit with us and spend our time with us, then it costs 10,000 rupees per month. But we can assure you that's still lower than any one of our competitors. We do this with the help of some good serverless technology, etc., where we reduce the cost of deploying your chatbot. So that is kind of how we are taking care of the pricing.
Okay, interesting.
What kind of traction have you had so far?
The platform is still under development. So we are waiting for the platform to be developed. But we've recently met two other customers who are also, we are also trying to handcraft chatbots for them. So we are waiting until the platform to be developed. We are still in the development phase. So once the development is done, we can give more numbers on the traction.
And then that use case that you gave with the college, what kind of effort is required to integrate it with their systems?
Yes, so we are trying to, we've created this kind of a chatbot just to showcase what you can do with our platform. So we are including all kinds of extension modules where you can build a chatbot like this within just a few clicks. For example, this chatbot uses data from the college website. So we are trying to build an extension module which allows you to scrape data from a page. So these kinds of things, and you can just use the data as a very, you can just use the data in your response. So it's very, I can assure you that it's pretty simple. It should be within just a few clicks and maybe 1 hour or 2 hours of your time. So